of the Immigrant Coalition Ever Island, which is a coalition of over 25 groups statewide, all fighting for the rights of immigrants and to protect the most vulnerable among us. I'm told that it hasn't been since the 80s since a coalition like that existed in Rhode Island. It's not only necessary, but it really, really shows how much support there is statewide from a cross-section of groups, whether they be faith, whether they be advocates, whether they be civil rights groups. And we're very happy to be here. Our immigration system is broken and increasingly more and more inhumane. Washington's dysfunction has made it so that the majority of undocumented immigrants have no way to obtain legal status, regardless of how long they've been here or how much they contribute to our society. But while the national landscape is bleak and the president uses every opportunity to malign and scapegoat immigrants, what's happening in Rhode Island should give us all hope. Common sense, bipartisan solutions are possible, and that's what we're here to celebrate. There are currently two pieces of legislation being considered in the Rhode Island Assembly that would allow undocumented Americans to apply for driver's licenses. While only the federal government can dictate immigration policy at the state level, we must act to protect all of our residents, and we know that issuing driver's licenses to undocumented immigrants in Rhode Island will lead to safer roads and potentially better economic opportunities. I want to thank all those who share their stories, all the dreamers that came out and shared their stories. Specifically, I want to thank Cristia Rivera, Jarusta Odinola, Javier Juarez, Rodrigo Pimentel, Darlene Melker, Emily Landero, Sergio Perez, Monica Scoop, and Lillian Calderon for testifying in support of these bills and sharing their stories. Without the human face affected by legislation, we can't really understand the magnitude of the problem, and it's their bravery and selflessness that has allowed Rhode Islanders to be able to understand this. And I'd also like to thank all the legislators that have proven that bipartisan and common sense solutions are possible, despite them not being possible in our nation's capital. Specifically, Representative Maldonado has been working tirelessly to whip support for the DACA driver's license bill legislation. Representative Pervasi, Representative Diaz, Felipe, McNamara, House Speaker Mariello, Senate Majority Leader McCaffrey, Senator Chacon, Senator Quesada, Senator Metz, and Senator Goodwin, and also Senator Chacon and Representative Williams. Thank you.